White. Pacers with the rebound. Hill's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. On the wing, Ellis lets the three fly, and the rebound goes to Lopez. Lopez has got three rebounds so far in the game. And for the Pacers, they're shooting right around 41% from the field in quarter three. Hill with it. Now defended by Freak. Goes back up. Patterson, that's good. Here's White. He has 45 points. Here's O'Quinn. Makes the bucket. Now he's got 5 field goals. 5 for 8 in the game. The Pacers shooting a respectable 47% from the field in this one. Dishes to Ellis. And foul hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. And you talk about huge single game scoring performances like we're watching here tonight. Going back, only one play. Think of this, only one play in NBA history to go triple digits. And that's the Big Dipper. Wilt Chamberlain on March 2nd, 1962.
Truly an iconic record. I mean, 100 points. I mean, it's hard to wrap your mind around. But Wilt was a man among boys, a player who changed the way an entire sport was played. Truly a revolutionary.
And Indiana making a change here. Scott's checked in. Ellis against a follow. And that one's good. 31 points for Ellis. And Clark, as we approach the fourth quarter, still anyone's ballgame.
Yeah, exactly right, Kevin. I mean, these teams just simply keep trading baskets, and as a result, trading the lead.
Yeah, neither team able to create much of a cushion. It's just hard to believe that someone can perform at such a high level. They've got to thank him for this lead.
The drive by Hill misses off the right iron. New York's gone 6 of 11 when they've taken the three-point shot tonight. Very respectable. Williams against Ellis. To the middle. Patterson. Good, and the assist goes to Ellis. Patterson's got his second bucket of the night.
And we always talk about making your teammate better. That assist was right on target.
Henderson kicks to O'Quinn. That's the sixth make from the field. He's taken 9 shots and missed but 3.
I like the recognition of the mismatch there, immediately making the defense pay.
Pick up by Hill. And Dudley kicks to Hill. And it's blocked by O'Quinn. Passes it to White. 102 left to play in the third.
Fellas, that two-hand monster slam was vicious.
I don't think there was anyone, and I mean anyone, that could have stopped him on that one.
I tell you what, I'm glad they didn't try, because somebody might have got their feelings hurt.
Pick up by Hill. Here's the feed to Patterson. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Patterson's got 6.
He didn't have a single point in the first half. Bagel, 0 points, nada. He's starting to get into the groove here in the second.
Out of bounds, Indiana takes possession. Turner's checked in for Patterson. And a switch here also for New York. Mazzilli's checked in for Williams. They play the clock right, then go 2 for 1.
Just got to time it up right.
Indiana moving it around. Hill has the open look. Hangs on the trifecta. Hill's got 6 in the total.
Really in a good position thanks to the accuracy from beyond.
Yeah, you got that right. I mean, you got it real right. They are lighting it up from beyond the arc, isn't it?
O'Quinn can't hit. Indiana's gone downtown a lot since halftime. They've missed 5 of the 9 attempts out there. Dudley against White on the arc. No luck. A follow. Cannot hit. And as we conclude the third quarter, what a game. Neither team giving ground. Pacers lead by 2. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter. We welcome you back to what has been a good one here as we get into the fourth quarter. checked in. White is checked in for the Knicks. And New York, looking at who they've got. White, he's in at shooting guard. Porzingis is out there with Festus Ezeli. Then it's Anthony. And it's Roten in at the one. Arthur dishes to Turner. Chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. Outside, White. There's the three. But they get it back.
There's another opportunity. Everything's going right for these guys.
And the shot is good.
He has definitely shown up to play. He's done his part, really just trying to bow his team back into it.
Deflects the pass. To the paint. Here's Turner. Nice pass. Nice catch and a resounding dunk.
Taking it to the rack with power right there.
Oh. Hammering down with the two-handed slam.
Just piling with the dunk like that. And really nothing like a good old-fashioned throwdown to get a team going.
And Greg, they do need to get going. Points off that lead right away.
Well, if the defense keeps giving up easy baskets like that, it won't be a lead for long. Incredible timing on the alley-oop.
He absolutely hammered it down.
And guys, mark that play right there, because that could be the one that leads to a surge to break this thing wide open.
Now here's Arthur, light covering. And George kicks to Arthur, like it's hits. From outside, off the mark. And a fast break now for New York. And with that shot, the Indiana leads cut down to two on the bucket from Porzingis.
No matter what the score is, his attitude has been perfect. I love his disposition. He has stayed in attack mode.
Here's Arthur. Indiana again missing.
Yeah, but the defense was determined not to give him an inch of free space.
Pass to Porzingis. And he misses the go-ahead basket. Indiana's gotten just one of four three-pointers to go down for them here in the fourth. And so he draws the foul on the shot on trip to the line to shoot two.
George having a fantastic game. He's got 21 points, and with 7 points coming from the free throw line, that's some good work.
It really is. He's going to have some bumps and bruises tomorrow, no doubt about it.
He's done a much better job of getting to the line here. Aggressively taking him inside and not shying away from contact. I thought he was settling a bit in the first.
Ellis is checked in for Indiana. Hill comes in for Scott. The 11-footer. Ezeli can't get it to go. Pacers leading by four. Hill passes to Ellis. And here we go. Three cut into the hoop. And it's sent back by Hill. With the ball, and Roten picks him up defensively. That's a goal from 11. Nice shot by George. George has got 15 points in just the second half.
You're starting to feel it from deep. Let's tighten up our pressure on the perimeter and make those looks tougher to get. We're going to give up the drive, but we have to rotate on the weak side to get there.
Yes, hi. Is my wife Brittany White there?
Yes, she is. What about dinner? Oh.
Yeah. Your phone, though.
There's a minute 40 left in the fourth quarter. That's it. Just 4 points with a bucket from Roten. For Indiana, they've got a pretty good rhythm going offensively. Shooting 8 of 15 for the quarter. George, double team. And stolen by Roten. And pushing it up. Here's New York. And that's the stuff.
And Kennedy is the play of the game right there.
A tremendous instinct spray to come up with a steal and then attack the basket.
Game changer right there, guys. An unbelievable play to make it this stage of a really tight ball game.
Here's Roten. Gets the ball.
Difficulty getting the ball inside here. The defense has done a much better job collapsing on them when they throw it inside. Double teaming and being active with their feet and hands.
A three. Paul George grabs the miss.
And that shot isn't the one they should be taking if they want to make this comeback happen. How about the determination? Now that's what we call competing for a rebound.
Roden dicks to Anthony. He dishes it to White. Out to the right wing. Anthony, the pass to White. Buries it. And he has brought them to within 2 points.
Those are huge points.
Beyond huge, partner. I mean, they needed that bucket depth.
And George, here we go. And the rebound goes to the Knicks.
And it's still within reach.
But they have to be really close to perfect.
Yeah.
You had me thinking he was on some fuck shit.
I'm like, damn, fool should be already done this shit.
I'm like, damn, you gotta make it. Shut up.
Yeah, I think my food is already done. I already paid for fucking oil.
We've got to be first. First to lose balls. First to the rim. We have to give our all right here. Kevin, now's the time.
And thanks for that story, Doris. 26 seconds left in the game. Outside, George. There's 14 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Man, how long is it going to take, man?
Oh, off target. White drives in for the win. It's gone. That's the game-winning shot.
Beat the buzzer beater.
And he wins it at the buzzer.
I won the best buzzer beater at Coco.
Wow, what a finish. What a remarkable way to close it out. Game time.
So a post game sees New York take this one.
I hear you.
They break the hearts of every fan in the building with a dramatic late victory.
And Kevin, this is
man,
the
game
you have
to take
a ton of pride in. I mean, they battled with everything they had and came through when the pressure was at its highest.
And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Norris from the sideline. Norris.
Well, a close call for you guys tonight, but you're able to pull it out. What did this team show you with its ability to pull out a close and narrow win like this?
I guess a big thing we learned is that this is a team for the children.
What?
Sometimes I get worried about that.
Thank you for your time. This one far from over, Kevin.
All right, Doris, thank you. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Clark, Greg, and Doris, and the rest of our terrific crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. And time now to hand over to Ernie Johnson for the 2K postgame show.
The 2K Sports postgame show.
Kevin, much appreciated, and now let's present our Jordan player of the game, Freak. He had it going on all game long, so when it came down to one shot to win the game, well, it was no surprise that he took it or that it was a game winner.
That was Freak turning up the volume right there, baby, all the way up to 11, and the stereo only goes to 10, Ernie, but we're at 11 right now. The man himself may be quiet, but his performance spoke very loudly.
He was completely on a different level tonight. And his insane point total tells us that. Trust me, it's not easy to get that many points in this league. But he had their number tonight, and the coach did a great job of continuing running plays for him.
And folks, that's it for us. Thank you for tuning in. Always a pleasure. For Kenny the Jet Smith, for Shaquille O'Neal, this is Ernie Johnson. Have a great night.